Hello and welcome to the episode 46 of What A Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Today's highlights include several live performances, a dress rehearsal, and a change in the recording procedure. On the 15th of February 1961, the Beatles, featuring Pete Best on drums, performed at the Aintree Institute, the 10th time at that venue. After the end of their performance, Roddy Neil Aspinall drove the lads at the Hambleton Hall for the second engagement of the night. Both venues were in Liverpool. 1962. After a lunchtime concert at the Cavern Club in Liverpool, the Beatles, still with Pete Best on drums, had another engagement at the Tower Ballroom in Wallasey, in front of 3,500 people, sharing the bill with Terry Lightfoot and his New Orleans jazz band. In 1963, the Beatles performed at the Ritz Ballroom in Birmingham. This was a rearranged night from the 11th of January. Between the original performance date and today, the Beatles had become a top three act, but the organizers had the luck of paying them the fee negotiated when the band was still virtually unknown on a national level. Such is the life of musicians. On this date in 1964, between 12:30 and 1 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, ABC TV American Bandstand had a live show featuring a telephone interview with the Beatles. In the afternoon, the lads were engaged with another rehearsal for the Ed Sullivan Show in the Napoleon Room of the Deauville Hotel in Miami Beach, Florida. After an informal rehearsal at 2 p.m., there was a dressed rehearsal in front of 2,500 people, most of whom had been queuing outside the hotel since the morning. After the rehearsal, the Beatles went fishing, hosted by some local fans. As they admitted later, it is likely that they rubbed shoulders with some mafia people while in Miami, but they simply didn't know. They were experiencing the States for the first time and weren't much interested in the people surrounding them as much as in their yachts, their swimming pools, the girls, and all of the other things that they had seen in films and read in newspapers, and that were now a very real part of their lives for the first time. In the morning of the 15th of February 1965, John Lennon passed his driving test in Weybridge, near London. Lennon was a notoriously bad driver, unable to find his way around and often easily distracted. He lost much of his confidence after crashing his car shortly after receiving the license, and, as a result, he was often chauffeured around by his driver, Les Anthony. In the afternoon, at 2:30 p.m. sharp, the Beatles reconvened at the EMI Studios in London to start working on new material. From this year onwards, EMI session sheets recorded only rhythm tracks and edits needed to complete a song, not documenting any of a dub added to a given take. To add to the novelty, this session also marked a new way in which the band approached the recording sessions. Instead of trying and perform a song live as completed as possible, and then add a few extra touches with overdubs, the Beatles proceeded recording only bare-bones rhythm tracks, subsequently overdubbing vocals and extra instruments on the best take to shape up the song. By 5:45 p.m., the band had recorded the only two takes needed to complete John Lennon's Ticket to Ride, which would turn up to be the Beatles' next single. The first was a false start, and the second was the best one. An unknown number of overdubs had taken place on the other available tracks, but we don't have any documentation on those. What we do know is that, in the end, the song featured bass and drums on track 1, George Harrison's 12-string Rickenbacker playing the main riff on track 2 with John Lennon's Fender Stratocaster and Paul McCartney's Epiphone Casino parts, John's lead vocals and tambourine on track 3, and hand claps, Paul's backing vocals and George's Stratocaster guitar part on track 4. From 7 to 10:30 p.m., the band tackled Paul McCartney's Another Girl, one take, 10 edits, and George Harrison's I Need You, 5 takes, both of which were left to be completed with overdubs taking place on the next day. A curiosity about I Need You. During the recording, John played snare drum on beat 2 and 4, while Ringo played the back of a Gibson Jumbo acoustic guitar as a percussion. Moving on to 1968, the Beatles' long-planned trip to India finally began when George Harrison and John Lennon flew to New Delhi today to study transcendental meditation with Maharishi Mahesh Yogi, followed by their wives Patti and Cynthia and by Jenny Boyd, Patti's sister. The trip had been already postponed twice in 1967, first for the death of manager Brian Epstein and then for the troubled making of Magical Mystery Tour. In the meantime, in Abbey Road, Lady Madonna was mixed down in mono for the first time, in a 4:30 to 6 p.m. session. Finally, in 1969, George Harrison, his tonsils having been removed, was free to return home from the hospital. This concludes today's episode of What a Fab Day. Please remember visiting www.simonmas.com/support if you'd like to know how you can show your support for my work. One of the ways is clicking on the bibliography link in the episode description and do your Beatles-related shopping via the Amazon affiliate links you can find there. You will spend the same amount of money you would normally have, and I will receive a little compensation from Amazon. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.